We have financial asset, financial liability, equity. We start off with, we have four definitions here. Financial instrument, individually, financial asset, liability, equity also have their own individual definition. So equity, we learned beforehand. Conceptual framework is actually your asset, your residual interest of your total asset less your liability. Asset less liability is your equity. So let's start with the first one. Financial instrument is a contract that gives rise to both financial asset to one entity, asset to one, and a financial liability or equity to another, of another entity. Means financial asset, one entity, financial liability, another, or asset one entity, equity to the other. Either liability or equity. I'll give you an example here. This is you, company A, this is B. You invest in company share. So the company issue you share, correct? Equity share. So to you, when you invest, it's an investment in company share, is a financial asset. To B, that issue shares, they are issuing equity. So just now, what is a financial instrument? It's a contract that gives rise to financial asset to one entity and equity to the other. Or liability here. You are, this is you, A. This is C, company C. Again, you invest, you lend the money, and then they issue you debenture, a 10% loan note debenture. So are you investing in C's debenture? It is a financial asset. But to C, the issue of debenture alone, to him, he will record it as a liability. Financial asset to one entity, equity or liability to the another entity. Okay. Asset is debit side, equity is credit. Liability is credit. So debit and credit. That credit can be equity, that credit can be liability. Okay. What is equity? Then we got financial asset, liability, equity. Equity just now is total asset, is the residual interest of asset minus all my liability. Equity is my asset minus all liability. Set up. Financial asset. Is asset that is cash. Cash is a financial asset. When you invest in another company share, equity instrument is also a financial asset. Or a contractual right to receive cash or another financial asset. Cash is an asset. So a contractual right to receive cash or another other financial assets from another equity entity, or contractor right to exchange the financial instrument with another in a condition that is potentially favorable. So, a contractor right to receive cash or other financial asset. Now that you have financial asset in C, Corina, do you have a contractor right to receive cash from C? Yeah, contractor right, because once you invest, you have every year, you receive 10% cash. But if you don't receive cash, it can be other form of financial asset. Okay, or it can be, and it can be exchangeable or convertible to other financial asset that is potentially favorable, convertible. Yeah. A contractual right, the 10% to receive the interest, or not the interest, not by way of cash, but other financial asset, or exchange with other financial instrument. Exchange with other instrument that is favorable to us. Convertible. Favorable, then we convert. Now, for this scenario one, does A has got a contractual right to receive cash from B? A, do they have contractual right to receive cash from B? Contractual right. So when you invest in share, what you get back is dividend, right? Do we have a right to receive every year, contractual right to receive? No. As in the company, if they don't declare, it's okay. If they declare, then I have the money, I'll receive. But if they don't declare, I cannot sue them. So there's no contractual right to receive cash here. But A, if they don't pay me the 10%, I can sue them. So I have a contractual right to receive cash or other financial assets. Okay? So, equity on this side, settle. Financial asset, now in the middle is financial liability. Financial liability is any liability that is a contractual obligation. Liability, we know, is an obligation to deliver cash or other financial asset to another entity. Pay cash or other assets, or to exchange financial instrument with another entity under condition that is unfavorable. So you are now company C. Company C has got a financial liability. Why? Because C has got a contractual obligation to pay the 10% interest, correct? Or they can actually exchange for others that is potentially unfavorable to the company C. This one is a liability. Unfavorable. Clear? High level SBR, you have C. Hedging. Hedging is the one that is the killer. Hedging. Hedging is one of financial instruments. They are more complicated. You have to learn your financial paper first, then you learn the financial management, you touch a little bit. Okay, hedging. So that's why here we only focus on A and B, but otherwise you still got C here. Now, physical asset, inventory is IS2, property, plant, equipment is IS6, Sixteen. Lease asset is IFRS 16, haven't learned yet. And intangible asset is IS 38. Okay, IS2 cost NRV. This one you have depreciation, straight line, revaluation, make sure you transfer excess depreciation. Correct? 16 haven't learned yet, IFRS 16. What is IS 38? Definition, intangible asset. Is a non-monetary asset without physical substance. Without physical substance. We do not recognize internally generated goodwill. Okay. But there are some internally generated intangible asset we recognize. Research and development. Research expense of right. It's a initial investigation undertaken by the company with the prospect of gaining new scientific and technical knowledge and understanding. I repeated about 1,000 times already. Okay, initial investigation undertaken with the prospect, with the hope of gaining something scientific and technical knowledge and understanding. So, just a prospect of gaining, so it won't generate future economic benefit, expense off. But development, what do we do? Yeah, you don't say development capitalized, no, but capitalized, but we must be the 6 PIAPAN, right? Pirate, okay. Then depreciation, it depends whether is it a finite or indefinite, finite life or indefinite. Finite, normally how I memorize finite, indefinite. This one I forgot to tell you already how to memorize. What is depreciation? It is finite life. Indefinite, finite means we have useful life. Indefinite means yes. So means when it comes to the spelling, this one longer, right? Means long life. Panjang. Okay. you have indefinite useful life, so we don't depreciate. Finite, yeah, we depreciate or we amortize. We have cost and revaluation model. Cost is just like IAS 16. Revaluation, also similar, up, down, reverse. However, we have a lot of restriction, right? What are the restrictions? Active market. Active market. Yeah, active market. One is homogeneous. Willing buyer, willing seller. And number three, it will be public. Yeah, the price is available to public. Actually, this is number one. You must for active market. Number two, it must be revalued regularly. And number three, all the assets in the same class must be revalued together. Cannot choose and revalue. Okay. I mean, we take this opportunity to do some revision. Okay, just to let you know, how much we have to catch up. We've forgotten, Okay, control of such physical intangible create an opportunity to generate inflow, but does not give rise to present right to receive cash. You see, financial assets here, we have the right to cash, share, or a contractual right to receive cash. When I own an inventory asset, but is that a financial asset? Financial asset is a contractual right to receive cash. So by buying an asset, inventory, do I have contractual right to receive cash from anybody? No. Similar to PPE. I just buy this one, table or chair. I don't have a contractual right to receive cash. A right to receive any cash. Contractual right is you have an agreement that the right. Sorry? Not much, but it's a contract. Contractual right. Means that this right arises because a contract signed between me and you. Okay, so example, I want to borrow money. So of course you want to borrow money, we have to sign an agreement. Yes, we have the agreement, we have a contract here. And the agreement says that I receive cash. So I now have a contractual right to receive cash.
So we are
sorry?
We are
fighting
the
asset
for cash. Yeah.
Why? Oh, you okay. But if you don't work, you don't get lah. If you don't work, then you don't get. No, no, you're nothing. You are liability. Okay. Next question. Probably now we mentioned about company with employee. Because you send them for training, and then you train them and then you groom them. Okay, now they become very skillful. And then of course then when they become skillful, more efficient and all this, and will help the company to generate income, correct? So are they your asset? Next question. Is employee your assets? If it's your asset, is it a tangible asset, intangible asset? Tangible, intangible. So employee, of course, by definition, yeah, it is our asset. Okay, but do we recognize here? We don't recognize here. Otherwise, you see your non-current asset. Oh, my employee, that is worth 2-3 billion. Okay, so one of the criteria of intangible asset to be recognized is control. Okay, yeah, they have no control over it. Okay, you can leave anytime, right? So this is in the standard, it's mentioned that they give an example. Okay, because you have no control on when they can leave, especially when they can leave anytime, like I said. Okay, so you have no control over your this asset, means you can't recognize. Another thing is you can't measure the value, correct? Cannot. So, same thing, cannot be measured with value. So we don't recognize them. It's an intangible asset. Football player will be different. Football player, yes. Football player is. Yes. Football player is an asset. Okay, they have 4 years contract. So you buy the company, you buy the player, you recognize your asset, and then you can depreciate.
Yeah,
amortize, depreciate, because the 4 years contract needs to depreciate for 4 years. I mean, generally, like that. Okay. Now, sorry. Yeah. Asset, which is a football player. All right, definitely here on why are all this not a financial asset? Because financial asset is the right to receive. By owning this asset here, I don't have the right to receive. It's just that they will generate inflow only. Okay, it will help me to generate future cash inflow. Does not give me rights to receive cash. Same thing as prepayment. I have overpaid my rental, okay, to my landlord. I do not I have overpaid for January and February next year. So do I have right to receive cash? No. So by overpaying 2 months, what I get in return is I get to stay for another 2 months. Okay, not? So it's not receiving cash, but receiving goods and services, the prepayment. It's not right to receive cash, but receiving goods and the services. Correct. They are asset, but not a financial asset. PPE and IS to inventory. They are asset but not financial asset. Okay. So on definition part, settle. So basically these three definitions settle. Financial instrument is a contract that gives rise to a financial asset to one entity and financial liability or equity of another entity. Asset, liability, equity, and three other definitions. Now, presentation and classification, especially on now we look at equity. Example one, when I issue 20,000 ordinary share, one share is 280. Issue cost is 2,000. So I receive 280 for one share. So I 20,000 share, it will be 56,000, right? What's the double entry for this? Cash or bank? Credit? Sorry, how much first? If I debit 56, I credit ordinary share, correct? 20. Share premium. 26, right? Then, I have issue cost here, credit bank, because I pay 2. Where do I debit? Sorry? Finance cost? Expense? No. I mean, finance cost is an expense. You're more specific. They are more general expenses, but both of them expense? No. But you debit share premium. Reverse out the share premium. Issue cost. This issue cost is related to issue of shares. So therefore, this 2,000 reverse from the share premium. Okay, the standard say we have to reverse here, and the Company Act also say so. Because share premium, we know cannot declare as dividend, correct? Company Act says cannot declare as dividend. So no other use. What can you use? Yeah, it can be used as a deduction from our issue cost here. No record in P&L. Credit and debit your SP, share premium. Because it's related to the issue of shares. Sorry? 36. Here, 36. So here, 34. When they incur the issue cost. So the answer here is already at net. The answer here is already at net. Yeah? I received net 54,000 only. My share premium is only 34, not 36. Because here we show two separate entries. Here we show net. No. I mean, it's two different transactions. two different transactions. And equity instrument is not remeasured. Okay, once you issue the share, the company issue share, that's it. Meaning today I issue how much? 280. My company share price is 280, so I need money, I issue 280, give me 280. And then later the share price went up to $5. This person is the owner. The share price went up to owner, so the owner will benefit. What do I do with my accounts? What must I do with my account when the share price went up? Comprehensive income. Credit share premium. Debit. Bank. Did I receive money? No. Actually, no need to do anything. No remeasurement. Okay. We don't do anything. Because today when I issue one share to you, I receive 280. The share belongs to him. And the share price went up to $3. To him, it's an investment. His investment went up. To me, nothing. We don't require anything. Huh? No, now we did not buy. We record. We issue share. We are the company. We are now is B. We are B. We issue share. We receive the 280. And the share price with him now, the share price went up 280 to 380. Yeah, so what must this company A do? We will learn that later actually, financial asset. The price go up means good luck, the investment up, income. With A, B don't do anything. No remeasurement. B, then I received the 280, I used the money to run the business. And money, the business make money, shareholder happy. Yeah. So the company don't do anything. Who benefit? The shareholder. Eventually, company profit up. This is to maximize shareholder's wealth. So this could be me. This could be other shareholder. So I run the business. So hopefully the business go well, do well, then my shareholder go up. Share price. Okay, maximize shareholder's wealth. And then the company make money. I can declare dividend to my shareholder, which is me as well, possible. If the share price go up, if it's me, then I'm going to record profit. But now that the share price, let's say, is 380, if the company want to raise additional fund, should be based on 380. Okay, no? Market price. Or normally, like what we learned earlier, just now, earning per share, 380, we maybe issue at $3 only. Then you will affect our earning per share. Okay, so we take a break.